I'm Jennifer. I'm an information specialist here at Hampton Park Library, and I'm standing in the Hampton Park garden. We were closed this spring, and our vegetable beds were sorely neglected and completely overgrown, as you can see, with grass and weeds, and we want to reclaim them. The master gardeners gave us a tip. They suggested putting down a layer of cardboard and then a layer of mulch on top in order to not only kill the weeds, but also kill the weed seeds and keep the weeds from coming back. This also provides a barrier where any new weeds that decide to join our beds will not be able to put down deep roots, and it's going to be very easy to pull them out of the mulch. Now, we had a beautiful tomato plant come back up all on its own, and I'm wanting to save that. And I do have another melon vine that came back in a different bed. So I have gone ahead and hand weeded that bed, and we're going to transplant this tomato plant first before we do anything else in here and try and save it. And I'm going to move it over to the melon bed because tomatoes and melons actually do grow well together. So what we're going to do now is transplant our tomato plant out of here. There's some weeds all around the tomato plant, and I don't want to transplant the weeds with it. I want to give it plenty of opportunity to grow without weeds choking it. So I'm going to actually hand pull some of the weeds that are really close to the tomato plant, and then I'll be able to dig it out and we'll transplant it over into the melon bed. I'm gripping these weeds down at the very bottom because I want to get the roots up. I do not want to transplant roots with them. It's definitely loose. Okay. I'm gonna take it in the surrounding dirt and we're gonna go put it in the melon bed. All right, I've pre-dug a hole here in the melon bed and I'm just going to set it down in here. I made my hole bigger and deeper than it really needs to be so that the roots have plenty of room to stretch out and grow. And then I'm just gonna take this dirt and put it around it again. And because the dirt's loose when it rains and when we water it, the dirt is going to settle a bit more. So I'm going to kind of mound it up around. And then I'm going to pat it down to stabilize the whole plant. I don't want it falling over or tilting, but I'm not going to pat it down too hard because I don't want to compact those roots. Now it's time to get this prepped for the cardboard. Because these weeds are so tall and so thick in here, I'm not going to be able to lay the cardboard down flat. It's going to end up letting light in, and I want to make sure that I get it down inside this bed. So I'm just going to take my weed eater and I'm just going to go ahead and cut this all down so that it'll go ahead and lay flat. Oh, always wear eye protection when you use your weed eater. What I've done now is I've taken my cardboard and I've prepared it. I've pulled off all of the packing tape off the edges because the tape is plastic and it won't break down. You don't want that in your garden. I've cut it out because I want it to actually cover all part of the soil that the light can hit. I don't want any light encouraging weeds to find a path back up. So any place that I have overlapped it, I've overlapped it by about 2 inches. But you don't want to overlap it too much or it's not going to stay moist. It's not going to stay wet and it's not going to break down into the mulch you want. So I've laid this out and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to water this down and soak it down. You've got to make sure it stays wet or it's going to form a hydrophobic barrier, which means that when the cardboard dries out, it actually becomes waterproof and it'll stop the water getting down into the soil underneath, and it can kill off your worms and your nutrients that the plants are going to need to grow later. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to water this and soak it really, really well, and then I'm going to put the rest of the layers down. So the cardboard is good and soaked and wet, and our next step is going to be to throw some mulch on top of it. That's going to keep the moisture in here, and it's also going to help block out the light as well from the plants underneath in case any of the cardboard moves. It also looks nicer and hides all your cardboard and holds it down so the wind doesn't actually blow it around and blow off all of your hard work. Our last step here is to put our mulch down. Again, we want at least 2 inches of mulch in the layer on top of the cardboard. I'm going to go ahead and I put my bags of mulch in the bed already. I'm just going to tear the bag open and dump it out. It's much easier than opening it somewhere else, shoveling it in. Just put it where you want it, open it. If the bag is tough and you can't rip it, feel free to use your shovel that you have out here to go ahead and cut the plastic, but we're just going to dump it on out. Spread it out. If you want to do more than 2 inches, feel free to. So as you can see, this is our final garden bed. We have trimmed back the weeds in here, saved any plants we wanted to save. We have laid down the cardboard, made sure it overlaps by 2 inches to make sure that light doesn't get down to the weeds underneath. We soaked the cardboard thoroughly. We want it to be able to break down and turn into a nice mulch. We've also layered at least 2 inches of mulch on top of it to hold the cardboard down, to hide it, and to keep the moisture in. Don't forget to ask your librarians for more great books about gardening. At Forsyth County Public Library, we know books.